Okay, everyone, we are done with the management practices employed in layer production. Now, let's move on to the management practices employed in raising meat-type chickens or yung tinatawag nating broiler chickens. Okay, we will be discussing the considerations or the prerequisites in establishing a broiler enterprise. Ano? We will also be identifying the main suppliers of the common broiler strains, what are the different systems of broiler operation, feeding management, and then we will have a sample computation for some of the production parameters in broiler production. Now, it is important to have at least a land or an area where you could establish your broiler enterprise or your broiler operation. In deciding the area, you have to follow, of course, yung recommended floor space. You have to raise only yung kakasya lang doon sa available land mo. It is also important to consider yung distance niya from the residential areas. As much as possible, dapat malayo siya doon sa town or city proper kasi nga yung waste or litter from the poultry farm, from the poultry farm is nangangamoy. Okay? And it is unpleasant. Alam natin yan. And then second is yung capital. Of course, in starting whatever enterprise or operation, you have to of course have a capital. You have to have enough financial resources. Okay? Financial resources are important to establish and sustain yung enterprise mo. We need to purchase yung starting materials, yung chicks mismo, yung feeds, yung medicines, etc. And then, speaking of the chicks, the feeds, the medicines, supply is important. Yun yung sinasabi natin. Okay? Yung may available supply ba ng broiler chicks? Okay? Is there an agricultural farm supply available in your locality na nagbebenta ng broiler chicks, ng feeds nila, ng medicines nila, etc.? Okay? Affordable ba yung available broiler chicks? So, tingnan mo rin kung kikita ka based sa presyo ng inputs mo at saka yung expected sales mo. Okay? And then, another important thing to consider is yung skills and experience. As much as possible, alam mo, may background ka sa broiler production. Kung wala, pwede ka namang mag-hire ng laborer mo, ng consultant mo, but this is only practical and economical if you will be raising a large population of broilers. Kasi kung konti lang yung gusto mong alagaan, hindi mo mamamaximize yung inputs mo, especially yung mga isusweldo mo sa laborers mo, sa consultants mo, etc. Siyempre, hindi mo masusulit, in short, yung pambayad mo. Okay? And then, another important thing not to forget is yung market outlet. When you start an enterprise, you have to have access to market. May target consumers ba sa lugar ninyo? Okay? May bibili ba? Okay ba yung price? Yung prevailing price? Okay ba yung expected price kapag i-market mo na or ready to market na yung mga chickens? So, kikita ka ba? Etc. Okay? And then, here are the common broiler strains and their respective suppliers. So, we have here yung Arbor Acre, supplied primarily by San Miguel Foods Incorporated. We also have here, so this is arranged alphabetically, okay? Avian strain, this is supplied by the Swift Foods Incorporated, etc. And yung pinaka-popular sa kanila, yung Cub, which is supplied yung ng Cub Vantres Philippines. And this is also supplied by the San Miguel Foods Incorporated, etc. Okay, so this is among the common strains, no? These are among the common strains of broiler raised in the Philippines, okay? And then we have here the different systems of broiler operation. We have here the all-in, all-out system or yung tinatawag nating AIAO system. We have here also yung two-stage operation, the multiple-stage operation, and the contract growing system. So let's discuss each one in detail. Okay? In an all-in, all-out system, only the broilers of one age are being raised. And all of them are sold at the same time. Kasi nga, iisang age group lang naman ang ilang alagaan mo. So, pag na-reach nila yung marketable age at saka marketable weight, edi binebenta mo sila once lang, okay? Siyempre, hindi mo naman pwedeng patagalin yung pagbebenta kasi malulugi ka rin, okay? Least efficient na sila kapag na-reach na nila yung more than 4 weeks na edad, okay? So, this is a simple disease control measure. Okay, so these are the advantages and these are the disadvantages. So, simple disease control measure siya, but this is considered the most desirable way. Yung all-in, all-out system. This is the most desirable among the 4 systems of broiler operation. Especially, if in one locality, community, or area, walang ibang age groups na inaalagaan. Okay? Kasi kung marami kang age groups na inaalagaan, the tendency is that mas mahihirapan yung disinfection procedure, yung cleaning procedure mo. So, there is a faster spread of diseases among the flock. Okay? Less mortality rate kasi nga mas maganda yung disinfection, okay yung disease control measures mo. So, better growth rate rin siya. And then, improved feed efficiency. Okay? Disadvantages. So, kahit na maganda siyang disease control measure, it is not suitable for large-scale farms. Kasi, ang problema sa large-scale farms, yung market nila. May target consumers ba na kukunin or bibilhin lahat ng birds, lahat ng available, marketable chickens. So, yun ay kung sa farm mo, kung large-scale yung farm mo, yun ay kung may processing farm ka din, may processing outlet. Okay? So, hindi yun problema kasi pwede mo siyang i-process into different products, di ba? Tulad ng lechon manok, fried chicken, yan, madami. Okay? Pero kung sa production ka lang talaga, it's not suitable to have an all-in, all-out system. Okay? Kung large scale yun. And then, higher fixed working capital. Okay? Higher fixed working capital kasi sa all-in, all-out system, wala na, meron kang brooder houses, meron kang grower houses. So, imagine, nasa brooding stage sila, yung mga chicks, so walang mag-o-occupy ng grower house. Pero kapag na-reach na nila yung growing stage, ilalagay mo ngayon sila sa grower houses. So, walang mag-o-occupy sa brooder houses. Okay? So, yun, higher fixed working capital siya. Okay? You're constructing 2 houses, yung brooder at saka grower houses, pero hindi siya continuous, no? Hindi continuous yung paglalagay mo ng chicks for each of the houses, okay? And then we have here the 2-stage operation. In here, from the term itself, no? 2-stage, so 2 age groups, okay, are grown or raised in the farm. Okay? With that, kailangan ng separate brooder and grower houses to separate the 2 age groups. Ano? So, with this, there is a more efficient use of yung housing and saka yung housing facilities. Sa all-in, all-out system kasi, sabi ko kanina, kapag nasa growing stage na yung mga manok, idle na yung brooder house. Walang laman. Okay? And vice versa. Pero dito, may laman both houses. May laman yung brooder house, may laman yung grower house. Okay? And with that, mas maraming broilers ang pwedeng alagaan, ang pwedeng i-raise. Okay? Another advantage is more frequent intervals of marketing the broilers. Okay? Say for example, when the first group is already marketable, may naghihintay na namang i-market after 2 weeks, kunwari. Okay? Etc. So, mas mabilis yung flow of cash. Ano? Okay? However, yung sa disadvantages naman is that you have to construct 2 houses. Ano? So, kailangan mo ng capital to construct, to establish yung dalawang houses na yun. Another is, transport is stressful. Alam natin yan. Kasi kapag na-stress yung hayop, whatever hayop that is, it affects yung performance. It affects negatively yung performance ng animal. Okay? And of course, you need more labor. Because of the 2 age groups. Okay? So, yung isang age group, iba yung requirement. Requirement in terms of feeds, okay? Requirement in terms of medicines, in terms of maintenance, etc. So, more labor, okay? Next, we have the multiple stage operation. This is also known as multiple batch system, or this could also be simply called multi-stage operation. Okay? So this is similar to the two-stage broiler operation kanina, but in here, we have more housing units to facilitate as many stages as possible, as many age groups as possible, okay? Because sabi ko nga, more housing units, more age groups are being raised in here, okay? Kasi, hindi natin sila pwedeng i-mix yung mga age groups, okay? We cannot mix the different age groups that we are raising because, sabi ko nga kanina, magkakaiba ang need or requirements nila, okay? And then, yung turnover ng manok can either be daily, every 2 days, weekly, bi-weekly, depende sa raiser or sa nag-aalaga. Depende kung kailan niya gustong mag-purchase ulit ng next batch ng manok. Okay? Multiple stage operation has advantages because you have a continuous production of chickens. And with that, regular and frequent yung slaughter of animals. May continuous supply no, ng marketable chickens. So may continuous income ka din. Ano? Apart from that, it is also easier to maintain customer base. This means that farmers can link or communicate with preferred retailers. So, namimaintain yung mga customer or yung suke na tinatawag natin. And they need not run around to sell every batch of broilers produced. So, hindi na nila problema kung saan nila i-market yung kanilang produce. Ano? Okay, we also need less capital outlay per batch because they can be moved, yung mga manok, they can be moved between different batches. Kaya may fund rotation tayo na tinatawag. However, so less equipment din ano. However, the presence of different age groups, okay, of broiler chickens on the same premises makes it difficult to clean and disinfect yung kanilang housing. Okay? Difficult to control the spread of diseases. Mahirap ang disinfection procedure or yung scheduling ng disinfection. Because of the presence of microbial or pathogenic materials from batch to batch, ano, the overall performance of the broilers in terms of yung gano'ng katagal mo silang alagaan, feed efficiency, what else? Mortality rate. Ayan, naapektuhan. Okay? So, poor uniformity. Siyempre, iba-iba nga yung age groups na inaalagaan mo. There's a tendency that is that there is poor uniformity in the flock. Okay? Kasi, kahit pa may meron kang laborer na tinatawag or meron kang assistant in your farm, record keeping or keeping of records, no? Lalong-lalo lang in terms of gano'ng kadami yung kinain nila, i-weigh mo pa sila, i-monitor mo, etc. Mahirap yon, okay? So, ang nangyayari, since kapag problemado or there are problems, no, encountered in record keeping, in monitoring, tendency is maraming, mataas yung mortality. Okay? Mataas yung mortality kasi aside from that, ineffective cleaning and disinfection. So, mafa-farther yung spread ng diseases. And that will lead to financial losses. And last is the contract growing system, which is essentially a partnership as illustrated in the diagram. Okay? Partnership agreement siya between poultry companies na tinatawag natin integrator company. Okay? And nung farmers or sila yung growers. So, yung integrator company, sila yung contractor. And yung farmer, sila yung grower. Sila yung mag-aalaga. Okay? And research shows that this system has generally worked to the benefit of these two parties. No? Both the contractor and the grower. Okay? And this is a system that has provided yung farmers an opportunity to participate in poultry production while allowing yung company or yung integrators the opportunity to invest more capital in processing and marketing the segments of this business. Okay? So, what are the responsibilities of the two? Yung integrator company or yung contractor, it provides yung chicks, yung feeds, yung medicines na kailangan, and it also provides yung technical services to the farmer. How about the farmer? Ang counterpart niya, siya yung may-ari ng lupa kung saan i-establish yung farm. Kasi minsan, ang tinitingnan ng mga companies, yung meron ng lupa at saka meron ng available housing. Okay? Yung land and housing facilities sa kanila, sa kay farmers yon, and pati na rin yung pag-aalaga or yung labor, kay farmers na rin yon. So, ano yung benefit ng dalawa? Yung output. Okay? Pag na-reach na ng mga manok yung marketable age and marketable weight, bibilhin ng contractor yung mga manok. San niya ibibigay yung bayad? Siyempre kay farmers. Okay? But, kapag bibilhin ni contractor yung output or yung manok, ileless na niya yung bayad ng chicks, yung bayad ng feeds, yung bayad ng medicines, etc. Kaya, ang mapupunta na lang kay farmers, yung difference. Yung natira. Okay? Okay, so merong advantages in for the side of the farmers and for the side of the contractors. Meron ding disadvantages for the faced by the farmers and by the contractors. So ano-ano 'yon? The prime advantage of a contractual agreement, no, for farmers is that the sponsor will normally undertake to purchase all produce grown. So, sabi ko nga kanina, bibilhin ni contractor yung mga manok upon reaching marketable age and weight. Okay? So, siya yung magpo-provide na si farmer yung mabibigyan ng inputs. So, magbe-benefit siya doon. And nung production services, yung technical services, etc. Meron din siyang access to credit. Okay? Meron din siyang, so ini-introduce din sa kanya yung appropriate technology. Sabi ko ang kanina, technical services. So, merong seminars, minsan na nangyayari, bago mag-sign ng kontrata. Okay? So, sinasabi ng company, ganito ang gawin mo, ganito yung protocol na susundin mo, etc. So, merong nangyayaring skill transfer. Okay? During or within the period na nag-aalaga ng manok yung farmer, meron siyang nalalearn na skill. Okay? And that farmer can apply yung mga skills na natutunan niya in the future. Okay? So, pwede rin siyang mag-alaga in the future on his own. Guaranteed and fixed pricing structures. Okay? Kasi bibilhin na, iisa na lang yung iisang presyo. So, they will agree on a price upon the chickens have reached marketable age and weight. Okay? Access to reliable markets. So, problema na ni sponsor yon. Okay? So, sponsor or yung contractor na yung bibili. So, may market na. Okay? May market na si farmer. But, what are the problems faced, no, by farmers? Okay? Ang nangyayari is increased risk. Kasi maaaring yung production could be affected negatively by weather conditions, ano pa ba, kunwari may bagyong paparating, even if maganda yung housing, no, hindi naman natin alam yung extent ng typhoon or natural calamities. What else, maaring outbreak ng diseases, isa pa yon, etc. Unsuitable technology. It might be yung farmers, it might be their first time, no, to raise broiler chickens, mga ganun. Or it could be that the technology or the practices that they are using, no, in their farm is not the same with what the contractor introduces. And this disrupts, no, yung existing technology nila. So inefficient management can lead to production of yung hindi magandang production, okay? What else? Manipulation of quotas and quality specifications. So, maaring yung contractor, ganito lang yung sinet. So, ibig sabihin, it could be that only a portion of the products produced or yung broiler chickens na inalagaan ni farmer yung bibilhin. Kunwari sabihin niya, 80% lang ng mga manok mo ang bibilhin ko kasi yung mga iba hindi maganda yung conformation, yung mga iba may mga pilay, merong mga namatay, etc. So yon, manipulation of quotas and quality specifications. So maaring merong standard yung contractor kaya hindi niya bibilhin lahat yung produkto ni farmer. And that is a problem on the part of the farmers. So corruption, price control, and then indebtedness. Okay? Yung sinasabi kong price control, since si contractor yung bibili ng mga chickens, na kay contractor yung price. Siya yung magde-decide kung anong price. So sasabihin niya, ito yung prevailing price in the market. So ito yung gawin natin. Ito yung ilalagay nating price for your produce, etc. Okay? Farmers no can face considerable indebtedness if they are confronted with production problems. So if the company provides poor technical advice, okay, significant changes in market conditions, okay, etc. Now on the part of contractors, so what are the advantages? So it can be more politically acceptable for a sponsor or a contractor to involve smallholder farmers in the production rather than to operate plantations. So mas maganda yon, no, na mag-contract growing na lang kaysa sa mag-operate or mag-establish sila ng plantations or ng estates. Okay? This overcomes na yung tinatawag nating land constraints or problems regarding the search for a site for to establish yung poultry production. So hindi na po problemahin ni company yung lupa. Okay? Kasi counterpart na ni farmer grower yung land at saka yung housing. Another is that when working with contracted farmers, this enables the sponsors or the contractors to share the risk of production, the failure of production rather, due to poor weather. Sabi ko kanina, this is incidents, pest infestation, etc. And this is also advantageous on the part of the contractors. Kasi the consistency of the quality of the product is met. Kasi sa iisang grower lang siya bibili. So, iisang grower lang yung source ng manok. That is, if maganda yung management ni farmer. So, consistent yung quality. Okay? Another one is yung mapopromote ni company yung farm inputs niya. So, that could be in the form of feeds, medicines, or other biologics. So, yung mga benta ni company, yung bibigay ni contractor na feeds, na medicines, galing sa kanya, galing sa company niya. So, in a way, mapopromote yung farm inputs niya. Okay? Makikita ni farmer yung performance ng mga manok based sa mga binigay or inputs. So, maaari, kapag maganda yung performance, maaaring sa susunod, dun siya bibili. Okay? Dun bibili si farmer. Maaring sabihin din ni farmer sa mga kakilala niya, oh, maganda ditong company, maganda yung produce nila, etc. Okay? And then we have here the problems faced by the contractors. So land availability constraints, lalong-lalo na kung hindi enough yung area ni farmer at marami siyang gustong ipaalaga. Okay? What else? Social and cultural constraints. Problems can arise when management chooses farmers who are unable to comply with strict timetables and regulations because of social obligations. Okay, paano kung yung pinili ni contractor ay barangay official pala or meron siyang other sideline or other source of livelihood. So hindi niya magaganap or hindi niya mafulfill yung responsibility niya as a farmer grower. So that could be a problem on the part of the contractor, okay? Another is farmer discontent. There are a lot of situations, no, which can lead to farmer dissatisfaction. So, ano yung mga yon? So, discriminatory buying. Maaring mababa yung presyo na ilalatag ni contractor kapag bibilhin na niya yung marketable chickens. Okay? Another is late payments. So, maaring kukunin niya ngayon yung mga chickens. Tapos, sabi niya, uutangin muna. Sabi ni contractor, late muna yung payment. Saka na yung payment, etc. Okay? So, ano yung gagastusin ni farmer? Ano, wala mo nang kita, ano? So inefficient extension services, maari din, no, maaring hindi regular yung pagbigay niya ng inputs, pagbigay ni contractor ng inputs. So, hindi masasatisfy si farmer. So, there is farmer discontent, sabi nga. Okay? What else? Input diversion. So, minsan kasi, ang nangyayari, farmers are tempted to use inputs supplied under contract, okay, for purposes other than those for which they were intended. So, maaaring yung mga inputs na binigay ni contractors, hindi ginamit ni farmer doon sa nag-agrihan nila ni contractor. Maaaring ginastos nila pambili muna ng bigas, okay? Maaaring yung mga binigay niyang feeds ay ibebenta, maaaring yung mga binili ng medicines ibebenta, yung mga ganon, mga cases na ganon. So, input diversion. Okay? So, dinivert sa ibang needs, sa ibang pangangailangan yung mga inputs na binigay ni contractor. Okay? And that is a problem. Okay? So, yun. Tapos na tayo sa systems of broiler operation. So, recall natin yung all-in, all-out system, yung two-stage operation, yung multiple stage operation, and then yung contract growing operation. So, along with their advantages and disadvantages. So, we have here feeding management, and as practiced, broilers are fed ad libitum from start to market. So, they are given feeds, no, in unlimited amounts, simula day old hanggang sa i-market natin sila. Okay? Yun yung ibig sabihin. And then, sorry. Recent observations indicate that high feed consumption, so yung feed consumption is positively correlated with growth rate, okay, and feed conversion efficiency. So kapag mataas daw yung pag-consume nila ng feed, so ibig sabihin marami yung feed intake, mataas yung feed intake, ang mangyayari mataas din yung growth rate. Okay, mabilis din silang lumaki. Mabilis din mag-convert yung mga animals, yung mga manok, ng feeds into produce. Ano yung output? Yung manok mismo, yung meat. Okay? So, these are the types of feed offered across ages. So, kapag 0 to 2 weeks old sila, ang bibigay natin is pre-starter or chick booster. 2 to 4 weeks, ang bibigay ay broiler starter. 4 weeks and above or until market weight is attained, ang bibigay natin is broiler finisher. So, last time may nagtanong sa akin, ma'am, ano ba yung age ng mga manok kapag bibigyan na natin sila ng starter? So, may mga nasasabi kasi sa akin na 12 days or 15 days. And ang sagot ko, pwede, 12 days or 15 days. Because, so, kasi napag-aralan natin yung gradual transition of diets. Kasi, so at 12 days, maaaring mong bigyan sila ng 25% na broiler starter and then 75% chick booster or pre-starter. And then, pwedeng sa 15 days kasi dalawa yung binigay niyang choices sa akin. So, do we give them at 12 days old or do we give them at 15 days old? So, yung maaaring at 15 days old, 100% broiler starter na yung ibibigay mo sa kanila. Kaya, tama yung dalawang choices na sinabi niya. Okay? You can give them at 12 days old and at 15 days old. Ang difference lang ng dalawa ay yung concentration or yung composition ng feeds. Ano? Yung percentage lang ng starter, yung difference. Okay? So, maaring, ma'am, ano yung, di ba dito 0 to 2 weeks ang ibibigay mo ay booster? 2 to 4 weeks ang ibibigay mo ay broiler starter. Pero, at 2 weeks old, the question could be, at 2 weeks old, ano yung ibibigay mo? Eh, sinabi naman dito, 2 weeks ibibigay mo booster, 2 weeks ibibigay mo starter. So, ano yung tanong? So, ang nangyayari kasi dito, bakit 0 to 2, then 2 to 4, then 4? Diba, kung ikaw yung mag-a-analyze, this should be 0 to 2, and then 3 to 4, and then 4 to 5, etc. But if you are to internalize it, no, there is gradual shifting. Ina-apply na natin dito yung gradual shifting. Kaya nadodobla siya, 0 to 2. And then 2 weeks, at 2 weeks, binigyan mo na siya ng starter, etc. So, I hope you understood yung explanation ko, ano. Okay. We're now on the last topic for broiler production practices, no? yung broiler production parameters, these are just sample, no? Sample of yung kasi variable naman tong mga values na to. Yung cost of daily, by the way, DOC means day old chicks, ha? So this 50 to 60 pesos kada chick, nagbabago naman siya. Depende sa time, depende sa panahon, kung saan mo binili, kung saan company, etc. Yung total feed consumed, 3.5 kilograms for the whole duration of the production cycle. So, yung feeding duration, it still varies, 30 days, but pwedeng 28 days or 35 days until marketable na sila. Weight at 30 days, 1.622, variable pa rin siya. Kasi depende rin sa management, there are a lot of factors affecting yung weight niya at 30 days old. Yung feed conversion ratio, magko-compute tayo mamaya. Mortality rate, 3-4%, that is acceptable. Pero kapag 10% na yan, parang may problema na sa farm, okay? Mataas na kasi masyado yung mortality rate. And then dressing percentage, ito yung hindi masyadong nagbabago, 70%. Okay? Labor ratio, ang ibig sabihin nito, you need one man to take care and manage 5,000 birds. So, 1:5,000. Okay, we have here sample computations for ADG. Ang ibig sabihin ng ADG ay average daily gain. This is a measure of growth rate. Okay? So, we have here a given yung initial weight niya. Ibig sabihin, yung weight niya, yung initial weight, yung weight niya at day old. Usually. Final weight, yung weight niya kapag ibebenta mo na, we have here 1,600. So, ang unit na ginamit natin dito ay grams. So, 40 grams and 1,600 grams or that is 1.6 kilograms. Yung growing period niya is 30 days. So, saan natin kinuha yung values na to? From the previous table. Although, sample computation lang naman siya. So, paano makukuha yung ADG or yung average daily gain? Ang ibig sabihin ng average daily gain, ano yung gram. Kung ilang grams yung gain niya per day. Parang yun yung ibig sabihin. Ilan grams yung nag-gain niya per day. So, we have here ADG is equal to gain in weight all over yung growing period. Total growing period. So, gain in weight could be computed by subtracting the initial weight from the final weight. So, yung gain in weight natin is equal to 1,600 grams minus 40 grams divided by the number of days na pinakain mo sila, 30. So, 1,600 minus 40 is 1,560 grams divided by 30 days. That is, ang ADG niya or yung average daily gain is 52 grams per day. Okay? Yan yung growth rate ng manok. Okay? Based dito sa values given. Okay. Speaking of growth rate, let me show you the growth curve for broilers. Although this is also applicable to other farm animal species. So this is actually a growth curve. Ang ibig sabihin nito, dito sa part na to, although hindi ko na siya babasahin yung caption niya, ang ibig sabihin nito, sa stage 1, ipagpalagay natin weeks yung mga gradations dito. Week 1, week 2, week 3, and week 4. At week 4, ilang araw yan? 28 days. Week 1, week 2, anong pinapakain natin from week 1 to week 2? That is booster. Dito siya na part. Anong pinapakain natin from week 2 to 4? That is broiler starter. So, from this period, mataas yung growth rate niya. Mataas yung growth rate niya, so pakain ka lang ng pakain. Pero pagdating ng finisher, hindi na kahit marami kang ipakain, ang ibig sabihin nito, kahit marami ka pang ipakain, hindi na yan tataas. So makaka-reach na yan ng plateau. So hindi na siya feed efficient by this time. Kasi nagsasayang ka lang ng feeds, nagsasayang ka lang ng pera, nagsasayang ka lang ng effort, ng energy. So dapat, anong practice or anong measure na gagawin mo, ano yung intervention na gagawin mo at this time, ibenta mo na. Kasi kung hindi mo pa ibebenta, magpapakain ka ng maraming feeds, hindi naman nalalaki, malulugi ka. Yun yung ibig sabihin nito. So I hope you will be able to understand this clearly. So yung y-axis niya, body mass. Ito yung number of days. Okay? So yan, mataas yung growth rate niya dito na part. sa kapag pinapakain mo pa lang siya ng booster, ng starter, mataas yung growth rate. So, ibig sabihin, hindi ka nalulugi sa feeds. Pero, kapag sa finisher stage na siya, pinakain mo ng madami, kahit unlimited amounts pa yan, kain niya ng kain, pero hindi naman niya nako-convert efficiently yung feeds into meat, ayan, lugi ka. So, kailangan ibenta mo na. Yun yung ibig sabihin nun. And then, we have here yung sample computation natin sa feed conversion ratio and feed efficiency. So, ang kailangan natin na values for computing feed conversion ratio is yung total amount of feeds na nakain niya for the whole duration of the growing period. Ang total na nakain niya, sabi natin, is 3 to 3.5. So, let's use yung 3 kilograms. Feeding duration niya is 30 days and ang weight niya at 30 days is 1.6. So, ang gamitin natin is 1.6. Ano? Ang difference, so although pareho itong FCR and FCE, pareho yung sinasabi niya. Okay? They can be used interchangeably, pero kung gagamitin mo siya technically, hindi pwede. Kasi ang FCR, that is input over output, yung FCE is output over input. Ano yung input natin dito? Yun yung feeds. Ang output natin is weight. Tama? Okay. Ang ibig sabihin ng feed conversion ratio, ilan ang amount or yung kilogram of feeds na kailangan mong ipakain sa animal to produce this output. Yun yung ibig sabihin. Yung FCE, gaano kadaming output ang na-produce given this particular input. Tama? So, yung input natin is feeds, total feed consumed, that is 3 kilograms. Yung output natin ay yung weight ng animal, 1.6 kilograms. So, 3 divided by 1.6, that is 1.875. Yung FCE, baliktarin lang natin, 1.6 divided by 3, that is 0.53. Ano yung ibig sabihin? Sorry. Kapag mas mataas yung FCR, ibig sabihin, marami kang kailangang ipakain, no? Marami kang kailangang ipakain na feeds para lang ma-produce mo yung output na ito. Okay? So kapag if the FCR computed is greater than this, no? Kapag ibig sabihin, say for example, meron tayong na compute na 2 na FCR. By the way, walang unit to kasi ika-cancel natin yung kilogram. Okay? Kapag na-compute tayong 2 dito, ang ibig sabihin, marami kang nasasayang na feeds. So, hindi magaling na mag-convert ng feeds yung inaalagaan mong animal. That could be due to a lot of factors. Management factors, environment, etc. Yung FCE naman, mas maganda na mas mataas yung FCE. Dito sa FCR, mas pangit or hindi maganda na mataas yung FCR. Mas maganda na mas mataas yung FCE. Kasi, mas marami kang napaproduce na weight even if konti lang yung input. Yun yung ibig sabihin. Okay, so I hope everything is clear for all of the topics under broiler production management practices. Thank you very much for being with me until the end of poultry production. Okay, see you next time. Okay, thank you very much everyone.